invite you to stand with us, and let's begin with a word of prayer, and then if you will, remain standing, and we'll join together in the pledge to the flag. I'm going to call one of our visitors, Superintendent of County Schools, Shannon Driver, to lead us in prayer, please.
Let's pray. Lord, just come before you today. We thank you for your many blessings. Thank you, Lord, for your goodness and your grace toward us. Thank you, Lord, for this land that we live in, the blessings you provide us. Just pray, Lord, your blessings in this meeting today. Pray that you'd always give our commission wisdom to know how to best serve the citizens of this county. And Lord, thank you for all your goodness and your grace toward us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Now join me in the pledge, please. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
I used to want to say play ball after that, but I don't want to say it no more.
I do want to tell you how much we appreciate your interest in the business of the county and the commission. Welcome all of you here today. We have several guests with us and a number of our staff and elected officials. Welcome to all of you. First item on the agenda is public comment from citizens. And Eric is here again, and Eric is the contract operator of Point A Park, and we'll recognize you at this time, Eric. He wanted to give an update, I think, on the current work that's in progress up at Point A. So,
So everybody's kind of up to speed with what's going on. We started on all of the upgrades. We finished with the primitive tent camping area. That's all complete. All of those proposed upgrades over at the day use park are all complete, with the striping of the parking lot and the repainting of the buildings and everything. Still have a little bit of ground clearing to do, but we were waiting for the lake to be drained for that. We've started it on the proposed 14 sites in the RV park. All of the water's been completely redone on all of those sites. We've started and almost complete on all the electrical on all of those sites. In fact, we had 6 or 8 of those sites up and running when the evacuees came up from Florida, and the power supply was so good at this point, we were able to stack big, large bus coaches, one behind the other, running multiple units off the same power pole, which you couldn't get anything remotely close to that before. Mm-hmm. So the power's all been upgraded on those sites. We have new boxes in on all of those sites. And never thought I'd see the day, we started last week on running our sewer lines for all of those new sites. So I'm working with Clay Elmore out of the county to get all that done and all of that sewer in, so we should have a top-notch park here pretty shortly, certainly before the end of the year. So.
Yeah. I know you had a visit from Power South officials last week, I believe, and they were pleased with what they're seeing so far, right?
Yes, what we did is, you know, early on, I think we've discussed this before, it was kind of a free-for-all where people were running utilities and stuff, and basically what we did was we laid it all out like you would see in a city or in a neighborhood where, you know, now everyone's going to know exactly where the power is, they're exactly where the water is. It's all been retrenched into code right alongside the road like you would see in any modern type of a development. So if in the future there is a problem, mm-hmm. someone knows right where to get it. We actually sectioned it off, and each site now has its own, like I said, own power supply. It has its own water supply with shut-off valves for each one, because before, if you had any kind of a problem in there with water, you had to shut the whole park down. No one had water. Now it's all been, you know, sectioned off to each site, so any kind of a problem, okay, no one else is affected. So
I know you've done some work on grade and drain, and that was a desperate need for the when you have the kind of rain we've had this summer.
We now no longer flood. In the last rain that we had, the rain did exactly, Lynn and I had, you know, kind of formulated a plan. Kevin had helped on it, where the drains needed to be and how we were going to do it. And we actually did all that project without having to cut out that outer loop road with the big 12-inch pipe. We didn't have to do any of that. Okay, we just put in a series of drain boxes and big pipe. So I think you had all seen the pictures where the electrical box was underwater. Mm-hmm. That didn't happen.
Good.
Flooded right, or went right out of the park. So.
Good. Good report. Anybody have questions for Eric on the park?
Appreciate what you're doing, and the picture we got of the evacuees and the time y'all, you know, just kind of had a little cookout and get together, kind of take the mind off all of what they was going through. Appreciate that.
Not a problem.
Thank you, Eric. Appreciate you being here today. All right. Any of the elected officials, Chuck? Others have comments you want to make at this time? Items. All right. Under the consent agenda portion of our agenda, we need to approve the minutes from the September 12 meeting. Commissioners have copies of those, and I assume you've had a chance to review those. Are there any corrections or changes, or is there a motion to approve?
I make a motion to approve the minutes.
Okay.
September 12.
No, I'm second.
Motion and a second. Anybody else have something they want to note on that? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Okay, minutes are approved. We have nothing under old business, so we'll move on to new business. The first item on the agenda is consider school sales tax request. And, you know, that's enough for a meeting by itself, but we have it on top of considering our budget for the year. So this is an interesting meeting for us. The school sales tax request is certainly important, of great significance for the commission, for the county, for the retailers, and I think it's worthy of some discussion and conversation. We have two of our three superintendents with us today. Michael Smithart from Iowa City, we appreciate you being here, Michael, and then Shannon Driver, we announced earlier when he opened the meeting with prayer. And I think what I'd like to do, Shannon, is maybe ask you to come up and address the commission. You guys took action at your last meeting or a recent meeting asking for us to take certain action on sales tax, and I'd love for you to kind of recap that and get our conversation started, if you don't mind.
Thank y'all for the opportunity to come, and I appreciate you all. I know some of you are able to come to our meeting and kind of hear some of our board members express their desire to see a half-cent tax increase. We've talked about this for some time, actually going back probably 3, 4, 5 years, and we felt like this was the better timing with some upcoming needs that we have potentially that we'll be facing the tax of Chairman White had mentioned. Probably we'll raise, I don't know, 2 to 2.2, somewhere around in that, with our portion being around half of that, and the other part, you know, divided between Andalusia and Ops. So each of the three school systems benefit greatly from this. As I said at our meeting, primarily, first and foremost, I want to have for Covington County Schools a buffer against what we anticipate being some significant federal cuts to our budget. We have, I think, around 50 of our employees that are out of our 400 employees that are funded by federal funds. Now, we don't know that that's going to happen, but that is the talk that we keep hearing from the U.S. Department of Education. A 10% cut in federal funds for us would probably be at least 10 to 15 employees. That's teachers. And that's something that it would be very tough for us to absorb a 10 to 15 employee cut. So first and foremost, you know, our request is to make sure that we have the reserve in order to take care of those things should they happen. We're hoping that those things won't happen and that they'll be able to level fund us. And if that occurs, then our plan, what we really want to do is to be able to enhance the programs that we have, add some additional programs to our current educational program, things that we can't do. We run a really tight, lean budget right now, and we would like to be able to add some additional local units. That's additional teachers at each of our 9 schools. That is something that principals could use very, very much. They run a very tight ship with the ADM, with the numbers that they have, and the classroom size. In addition to that, we see an opportunity to add some additional programs in our curriculum and do things. One of our board members has mentioned at our meeting the need to add an arts program. We've added a music program to all of our kindergarten through fifth grade. We would like to add an arts program to that to enhance our current programs. There are just a lot of things that we have kind of in the pipeline that we've never been able to consider before, but this would allow us to do some things that would really improve the school situation in Covenant County Schools, and we appreciate you all being open to considering that addition today.
Okay. Anyone have questions for Mr. Driver while he's at the podium?
You did say that all the teachers are federally,
through
federal.
About 50 of our 400. We have 400 employees.
But I mean, you're talking about all the employees, but all not all the teachers are federally.
No, we've got 250 teachers, and about 40 of those are federally funded units. Yeah, and then we have some federally funded non-teachers like aides and things like that. That are not federally funded, but those 40 to 50 teacher units that federally funded are a lot of those are special ed teachers. Some of them are other type federal units, but that's where the cut would just be devastating to us.
Yeah.
Do federal funds flow through the state, so you will
right.
get word from the state when?
That's right. That's right. It all flows through the State Department of Education. And that's up in the air. I mean, nobody really knows. They're talking cutting in the upcoming budget, but we'll see.
Anybody else have a question?
Any other thing on the sentence that, he resigned,
yep.
and the replacement for him or whatever?
Really don't know right now. It's a big question mark as to where things were going to go there. They have an interim right now, this former state superintendent, and he's kind of right now trying to get the state in compliance with the federal government because our federal funds depend on our state being in compliance, and we're not in compliance right now with the plan that we have to submit. And the U.S. Department of Education gave the governor 30 extra days to submit that plan. So that's his number one priority, is trying to protect those millions and millions of dollars coming from the federal government. So I know we fuss about the federal government a lot of times, but you kind of get used to those dollars. And we put 90%+ of our federal dollars go to salaries. That's where they go.
You mentioned the foundation formula, the distribution of the funds. That's
yes.
under the foundation formula, and it will continue to
that's
be.
Right.
That's the only way that can be that any funds we would collect can be distributed. Presently, the distribution to city of Andalusia is. Look, is that the number?
Mm-hmm.
26.
Okay.
Yeah, 26.883.
Okay, and then
City of Op Board of Education is 21.549.
Okay.
Round numbers. And Covington County's distribution is 51.567%
right.
of projected sales and use tax. If we were to pass that, which is projected by Revenue Discovery Systems and that handles our collections has $2.4 million round figures.
Okay.
So a little better
okay.
even than we had anticipated. Okay. So $2.4 million for a half-cent tax, a little over $1.2 million for the county schools.
Right.
And then
that would be something also that would change year to year, the ADM.
The formula, yes.
That's right, because right now we're just about the end of our 20-day report, and so after that the state
it'll
would
be
release
reset.
The ADM, and then I'm assuming whenever this is collected we would calculate it off the new ADM.
Yes.
unless it's not prepared.
Yeah, whichever one's in place from the state. Because we distribute sales tax and other taxes to you guys presently under the same directive, and it'll just change as that changes. We appreciate you being here. Anybody else have questions before we dismiss him?
No.
Thank you very much.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Also honored to have Michael Smith, our Ops City Schools. And Michael, we've had conversation. Be glad for you to address the commission, talk about what you see from these funds and what you think your board will want to do if you were to receive the additional funding.
Yeah, I'll try to be as brief as possible. I think Shannon did a very good job of hitting the need, primarily relative to the potential cuts in federal funding. When the foundation program in Alabama was established, you know, it's to provide a minimum level of education. Well, when you run the numbers to fully fund a student's education in Alabama through classroom, transportation, child nutrition, all the auxiliary services and all those sorts of things, it takes about $7,500 per student to educate a child in Alabama. The state of Alabama provides us about $5,000 per student. So if you take and you do the numbers, if the state of Alabama simply elected to fully fund the foundation program, we would have an additional $2.5 million in the city of Opelon to provide education. That's not going to happen. It's up to us locally to provide the funds to provide these services. And I think the angle I want to take on this is that when I graduated from Red Level High School, the expectation was that I had to compete with a student from Andalusia, Pleasant Homes, Strawn, Florella, just around here. That's primarily what we did. You had to compete with the person next door for jobs and that sort of thing. Now the expectation is that our students will compete not only statewide, nationwide, but globally for jobs. So what we have to do is we have to provide an education that allows them to go out into a world economy and compete for those few jobs that are available. Now, In order to do that, we have to provide the resources because there's really only two reasons why a student from Covington County can't go out and compete globally. There are only two reasons. One is they're not good enough, and the second reason would be that we can't provide the resources for them. Well, I am not willing to accept the fact that kids in Covington County are not good enough to compete with anyone globally. So it's up to us now to provide the resources so that they can go out and make a contribution and make a difference in the world. And the way you do that is when you provide these extra funds, you're able to provide the extra things. We're going to provide a minimum level of education. We're going to provide English, history, science, and math. But career technical programs, those require additional funding because they cost more. That allows us to do that. And that's what we need to be able to do. We need to put in these programs that allow us to train kids to go out and compete for those few jobs that are available, and then hopefully in turn bring that back and we get money back, because to me, you don't spend money on education, you invest money. I think every dollar that goes into a school is an investment. And I hope that you see this, and if you're able to pass this tax, I hope you view that as an investment in the future of this county and into the children, because we're very blessed to have three really good school systems. It doesn't matter where a kid in Covington County goes to school, they're gonna receive a quality education. And so we're lucky in that. And my hope is that we can continue to do that. And with your help, I think we can.
Questions? Comments? Anybody?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate you being here. So the request from the county school board was that we consider a half-cent tax, sales tax, for education. Just a reminder, county commission can only impose a sales tax, and then only for education. We don't have any taxing authority beyond that. Any revenue source that we might have as a commission for our operations and so forth has to come through the legislature or through the ballot. So this is the only taxing authority that this commission has. There's a copy of a resolution there. There's one in your book. Let me get Karen to pass out one that she has. It's updated a little bit. Probably the best thing is just to read it, if you don't mind. I'll tell you, I'll forego the code sections. but it's that's in the verbiage. Whereas Code of Alabama authorizes county commission to levy a county sales and use tax exclusively for school purposes, and whereas all school systems operated in Covington County, Alabama, Covington County Schools, Ipswich City Schools, and Andalusia City Schools have expressed a need for additional revenue in order to effectively carry out their missions and to enhance education for the children of this county in future years. Whereas the code authorizes county levy of sales and use tax in order to generate revenue for education, and the county commission shall administer and levy these taxes through the commission's efforts or through other third parties as the commission deems appropriate. And whereas all revenues collected under the provisions of these code sections shall be distributed within the county on the same basis as the total calculated cost for the foundation program for those local boards of education within the county, or according to such distribution formulas may be properly enacted in the future by action of the legislature or the courts. Therefore, be it resolved that the Covington County Commission does hereby adopt the following sales tax, consumers use tax, and sellers use tax increases in Covington County as provided for in Code of Alabama, and it has the rates set out, general and vending 50%, auto 0.25. Let me go back. General and vending 0.50%, half cent. Auto 0.25 or a quarter of a percent. Farm 0.25, quarter of a percent. Manufacturing machinery 0.25. Be it further resolved that the tax increase for school purposes is set forth by this resolution shall be collected pursuant to Alabama law for all sales beginning on January 1, 2018 in the same manner and by the same means as is properly identified by the commission presently or from time to time. Further, if it is determined that the imposition of this tax requires adoption of ordinances or other formal action, the passage of this resolution documents the commission's intent to fully comply with the law, and appropriate action will be taken to fully comply with the terms set forth herein. And so that's what's before us for consideration. I think it encompasses all that we've been asked to consider as a commission. So you heard the resolution. Rather than take action on that, though, I would love to recognize Andalusia Superintendent.
I apologize. I was in a number of facilities assessment.
Well, you said you had some conflicts today. The other, your cohorts there have addressed the commission. Be glad for you to come up and address the commission if you'd like to do that, Ted Watson. We're limited them to 30 minutes apiece.
First of all, thank you all for consideration of this proposal for education. I don't know. I think it shows a great propensity to pay things forward. I don't know how it happens in Alabama that education sometimes seems to be demonized as being wasteful of money or whatever the case may be. I fully believe that that some of the best values you get for your dollar are here in Covington County. Whether it be Ops City, whether it be Covington County or Andalusia City Schools, people in this area are well blessed to be a part of and have at their disposal a public school system or systems as highly thought of throughout the state as the Covington County school systems are. I know that education of your kids, education of your constituents' kids are high on your priority list, and I think that your action today shows that. And I know that there are, we don't always see eye to eye on things or whatever the case may be, but at the end of the day, your actions today show that all kids in Covington County's best interests are being served. And so I would say thank you for that. I know it takes any time taxes are mentioned. That's a three-letter word as opposed to a four-letter word, which in today's society can be worse than four-letter words. But I just say thank you for your efforts and what you've been, what you're putting together today, and it does not go unnoticed. I appreciate that.
Anybody have questions for Ted while he's at the podium? Comments about him?
Well, again, I do apologize. I got caught up in a facilities assessment, and I told him I had to go, but if he's broke along, I apologize.
You know, the
You're
only
right.
The only thing I would like to see is this, is I, listening to all three of you, it does feel good to hear all three of you say that you can get the quality education from any of these school systems you're in. That means a lot, I think, to all of us, knowing that there's not any animosity or any problem amongst the schools themselves, and I appreciate that. I appreciate that from all of you.
Well, sometimes the competition on a field or a court has a tendency to bleed over into people's minds when it comes to the administration and actual policies of a school system. I can honestly say these two guys haven't worked with them for quite some time. I'm going my eighth year here with Andalusia City School System. It's more than just cordial. I think we work well together. We communicate well together. We put the best interest of kids in our school system and the county. We put their best interest at heart. So that, at least, that's what we try to do, huh, guys?
Like you said, I don't know the teams playing and all that, that does, but when somebody goes out and excels in the world, they always look back and say, he's from Andalusia, he's from Covenant County, and it makes us all proud.
Yes, sir. I will say this, and I'll sit down, because I'm not from this, and unless you're from here, I don't know if y'all are from, if you've ever lived outside of Covenant County or not, you should really be proud. I'm not, so I can say that. One of the best compliments you could give to your school, this is before me or Michael or Shannon came aboard, but it continues even today. One of the best compliments you can give a school system or an educational system is to look around and say there are no private schools. And because they will divide a community in about two shakes. And I come from that, and I know from what I'm talking about. So I think quality is something that we all strive for, and I think we've attained. Anything else?
Thank you.
Thank you, Tim.
I thank you all.
Thank you.
Yeah. Commissioners, we don't have a motion or a second. You have a resolution to consider and kind of start from, if you'd like.
I'd like to make a motion that we implement the sales tax for education housing as written.
Okay, there's a motion. Is there a second?
No second.
All right, there was a second. Let's discuss it, make sure we answer questions, concerns. There are some issues that I know we've had conversation. Action rather than have a special call meeting or delay till another meeting. What I'd like to do is just continue this current meeting at a later time, and we'd look at Thursday or Friday of this week or Monday of next week. And I think Friday maybe had a conflict, so we would look at Monday if we do that. But so if there's a second, if you want to make a motion, Joe, to table this till Monday at the continuation of this current meeting, that'd be appropriate, or you can do something different than that.
I would like to move to have a meeting Monday or convenient time if
table this
can attend.
Okay, table this for a meeting, continuation of this meeting on Monday. So it'd be within the same meeting, just at a later time.
I think Thursday, Friday might be a little quick. Okay. It won't give them time and us time to get together on a couple of issues.
Okay.
I agree with you on that, and it's not that I'm opposed to the tax at all.
No, I'm not either.
I don't think anybody sitting up here is opposed to the tax. I think that we do have some questions that we'd like to get answered on it, and although I see this tax probably passing, I do think there's questions we need answered, and I would second the motion.
So there's a motion to table. There's a second. Can't debate that. All we can do is a vote. So what I'd like to do is we'll just take we'll do a roll call vote. Kenneth?
Yes.
Joe?
Yes.
Tony.
I'm sorry.
Is it, we're roll calling the, to vote on the motion to table it till Monday. Kyle is enough. So the motion to table carries, and we will table it until Monday at a continuation of this current meeting. And so if y'all have a few minutes to hang around, we're gonna recess in a few minutes. I don't want y'all to be stuck here through a budget hearing or budget discussion. But if you hang around a little bit, maybe Joe, Tony, the others that may have questions or concerns, you want to get to these guys before they get out, catch them for a minute. Let's do that. Anybody else have a question, though? Generally, we've tabled it, but I think it'd be appropriate if nobody objects. If you have a question, concern, thought that you want to bring back to the group. Okay. Tell you what, it's pretty early in the game, but let's recess for about 15 minutes, and we'll come back in here at 9:50. All right, we'll recess.